He really already moved in.
Engrossing. I don't people gonna be on the edge of their seat.
Sometimes you get to know people. You know what I'm saying? How your day went, you know? And you end on top of that, did you have a good day?
Today was a good day. She was lit since.
Oh, you got lit? You drink that early? Yeah. What made you do bartending thing anyway?
Something I always wanted to do, but I did it like 8 years
ago. Why do you drink so heavily? What are you running from?
What? Justin, what? You always trying to dig for something that's not there.
As a friend, I'm concerned.
Are you really concerned?
I am.
We're not supposed to talk about me today. We're talking about Omarosa.
Omarosa. Well, actually, we're talking about Kanye and Jimmy Kimmel, but you didn't.
Nobody wants to talk about Kanye. That's like last week's news. Who cares?
That's how it works. The news cycle. You don't roll with it.
Fake news.
Yeah, the way.
See what didn't happen. Okay, what about Kanye tweeting that he knew what he was? He didn't. He wasn't dumbfounded. It was just a deep question. He didn't want to get some people thinking about it, and Jimmy cut him off.
I don't even know, because I really didn't watch the interview.
You did your homework.
I didn't even look at anything about it.
So since you don't know anything about that, we have to talk about you.
Okay, let's talk about it.
So, what's going on? How are you doing?
I'm doing great.
Great?
Great.
Are you taking sweet?
Yeah, this is raspberry iced tea with a lemon.
There's a whole lemon in there for the record.
A lemon wedge.
Who slices lemon for their personal drinking? But, you know, whatever. But anyway, I feel like, because I feel like the whole Trump Omarosa thing will go real quick. We all gonna say,
I mean, what is there really to discuss?
Exactly. Like,
for me, when it comes to shit like this, the actual thing that they're talking about, the black and white of it, Omarosa going to the White House for whatever goddamn reason, he pulled her in and her recording phone calls and then now putting it out, that's kind of mundane bullshit.
Well, she's putting it out because she has something to sell.
But that's the more interesting part, the depths of disloyalty and conniving and that kind of, but that part of it. Then also another part that interests me in this is, this is one point where I can feel the black woman's plight.
Oh.
High five.
Good. I ain't gonna say seven, but I'm just saying.
No, Maurice.
Maurice, you saying names?
Yeah. Sorry, Maurice, you still my homie.
We're gonna get to it tonight.
Yeah.
Nah,
I'm working, don't worry. All right.
I'm gonna play the cop.
You always do. You try to.
But no, yeah, with a black woman like her, she got no win in this.
She has no win?
She has no win in this situation. He gets to call her a dog, a.k.a. a nigger. Black people are going to be upset at her because she's not pretty. And that's not me. She's not the pretty, light-skinned, white woman, black woman. So people are going to like, she's the atypical black bitch.
What?
That's interesting. No. I get it. Just her whole persona is the hard black.
She's a black woman. Angry black woman that you see arguing in the store.
Yeah.
And everybody is going to pounce on her.
Well, I mean, I think
she got no win in this situation.
It's very interesting. I think people are conflicted. I've seen some people that kind of like, well, fuck her. She deserved that shit. She shouldn't have broken the road with Trump in the first place.
That's the overwhelming thing with this.
And then, it's kind of easy because a lot of people are on the whole, but then again, the people that hate Trump, of course, going to take any reason to shade Trump. I mean, not that this isn't a reason, because, like, it blew me. Like, I read it. I'm like, dude, what the fuck, bro? Like, I mean, at this point,
I need to turn it down.
You ain't even trying to hide the shit anymore. Like, it's to me, it's like he's slowly and slowly getting more comfortable and not even hiding the shit anymore. Like, you can't call a black woman a dog, bro. You just can't do that shit.
So, if it was Stacey Dash, would we care?
I would, man. Because the politics.
It shouldn't matter who the person is.
Politics shouldn't matter. I mean, no.
Because she's. Feats, I mean, she.
Which also, I think, but Stacey Dash is.
Oh, wait, Stacey Dash, the crazy.
Yeah.
I guess that is a good one.
Define crazy.
That's a good comparison.
I only said that because of. Number one, she's the opposite of Omarosa.
Yeah.
in terms of physical appearance. Mm-hmm. But then also, she is, I think she's supposed to be a Republican, and she was the one that we were trading.
Yeah, she on the same page.
Right, so that's why I threw that out there.
She's a little bit further down there.
Omarosa.
You got to think that if they run, if the Democrats run a person as a candidate that's anywhere more likely than Clinton, if they run Bernie or Biden or Booker or somebody that's anywhere near charismatic, that's going to get any kind of, you know what I'm saying? That any kind of bump for what Hillary got, you get a bump for that. You get a lot of people who voted Green Party who, to get Trump out of there, is going to go Democrat. And then if you got this nigga tape out there, that's going to, you know what I'm saying? Like, I think he loses that little margin of victory that he had.
My thing is that I think
he already out of there, but something like this is kind of, I think that'll solidify.
I don't think that, I think this is all about, all in faith of democracy, what you're saying. And I don't believe democracy is, like the fight that Democrats have right now is the wrong fight. I'm watching them and they're fighting for democracy and not realizing that these people are saying they don't like democracy.
Yeah.
They're done with democracy. It's too fucking fair. So much so that he's lining up with dictators all across the fucking world and getting rid of all the democracy-based countries. And he's lined up with the dictators.
Yeah.
Right. That we notoriously have been against all these years. He's linking up with all them, the communists and all these people, and basically doing away with democracy. And it seems like from the Russia point of it, what Mueller and all these people are fighting, is that they use white race. They figured out that what's the cancer of the United States? Mm-hmm. What could kill this empire? And its own racism that it was built on is what they used to kill it. So they used that white thing to get themselves in position, and they came in, and that's what he used. So is Trump this big raging racist? I don't know, be honest with you. I can't think that this guy is for real, but I do know that he used that shit to get where he is. I know those dog whistles, literally, no pun intended, you know, but dog whistles that he put out there is definitely feeding to them when he says those things.
You know what? Honestly, like, and I was where you was around the election. I was like, well, you know what? I'm trying to get a man the benefit of the doubt. I don't think he out racist. I think he's court racism. But like, nah, man, cuz racist.
I mean, it don't matter.
It don't matter. But I think, I mean, it's just, I don't see the viability in that. I think it's enough people that are on the right side of history when you really twist their arm.
So that becomes what? A civil war.
No, I don't think it becomes a civil war because I think the mistake the Democrats continue to make is that they don't have a plan for poor people. As messed up it is to say, poor blacks are okay with handouts. Poor whites don't want handouts.
Poor whites don't want handouts?
They don't want handouts. They want
I get it. They want their jobs that look like we got.
Jobs. They want to own their
house. And Mexicans got.
You see what I'm saying? Like, it's... And again, like, I mean, that's not a knock. I mean, I think it's deeper reason as into why that is. And I think because black people are so displaced and so disfranchised that anything looks good. You know what I'm saying? If somebody going to pay your bills for you... You know what I'm saying? If somebody pay your bills for it, you like, fuck it. At least they giving me something. Mm. But ultimately, like, yeah, because Section 8 ain't shit. Because if you on Section 8, you paying $25 a month for your crib. Because like I said, I rented my crib out to a lady who's on Section 8. I come by there, and like, I don't know why, but it's like, I swear to God, because it's a McDonald's right down the street from my house. And I can tell you that the distance between my house and the McDonald's is how long it takes to eat whatever you get from McDonald's. Because I get so many fucking wrappers dropped right in my yard. You know what I'm saying? I swear to God, whatever distance that is how long it takes to eat a burger.
Yeah.
Because motherfuckers, like, once they get to my yard, they toss them. So I come by there and this shit all in the fucking yard. You know what I'm saying? And the thing is, it's like, but she renting. So what the fuck does she care? She put it right in the garage, close the garage, she don't see it. Me, now that, like I said, I move back there, I'm picking shit up. You know what I'm saying? And motherfuckers saying like, damn, man, you keep that yard clean. That's what's up. Like, dudes act, dude. And my neighbor came and asked me, like, yeah, the last place she said, I was like, no, I own this motherfucker. He's like, you know what? I can tell. Because old girl was like, you know what I'm saying? Because my thing, because the motherfucker come cut my grass, he ride her over this shit.
Right.
I'm like, nigga, like, what for break? You know what I'm saying? Whatever. So, but I own the property. It's, I have a vested interest in making sure my property stays valuable. Especially when it's a, you know what I'm saying? It's an abandoned crib next door.
But are you supposed to be owning that crib in America?
That's a different conversation.
But that's where I'm at, though. That's where my ship is going.
No, I feel what you're saying. But anyway, like, just let me cook my point, then we go.
Yeah. There.
So my thing is this: is like, with black people, they like, fuck, give me Section 8. At least I got somewhere to stay.
Mm.
These real white people's like, I used to be on. I had a job at a coal mine. Mm-hmm. I was one of the biggest cats. You know what I'm saying? Richest cats in the city.
Right.
Everybody was trying to get where I was at. Right. They moved that coal mine. They moved that factory. And now I'm fucked.
Well,
I want that again. I don't know. You can give me aid to where I'm living the same exact lifestyle. But no, I want to get mine.
That's where I start the question: is he really racist? Because that's when you get down to the fact that he's lying to them too.
Well,
it's all a big game. He talking about, I'm gonna bring coal mines back, and they like, yeah, and we're gonna do that. We're gonna build a wall, and now all of a sudden we're gonna build a wall, and we're gonna make Mexico pay for it. Meanwhile, they're not really paying attention, because meanwhile he's fighting Congress about paying for it.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, he about to shut the government down because they won't pay for the wall. Well,
but the thing is that he's using their tribalism.
Right.
They're kind of coded racism to kind of appeal to them. And that way, he don't have to do anything for them, but agitate them.
But make them above blacks.
No, they exactly.
That's the same old thing, right?
Exactly. He gives them a boogeyman.
Right, they give, put
those
them
brown,
put them
up. Those Mexicans are taking with all this money we're paying for these Mexicans. We get them out, keep them out of our country, we good.
I feel like you're fighting racism.
No, he's racist as fuck.
No, you're fighting the racism. You're making him a racist, but you don't want to believe in the total racism of the society. They're looking for to be above. The nation have promised them to be elites.
Yeah.
And he's making them, and it started looking like they stopped being elite. You're talking about the house you own and all these things in part fours in a neighborhood that used to be all white.
Yeah.
And where are the families who used to live in Park Forest? They going somewhere. They're displaced now. They're displaced. And now they're looking like, what the fuck? This is America. This is ours. How the fuck is all these? We even got a nigga president.
Well, this is the thing. I get where you're going. I'm not willing to say that everybody. I think, okay, I'll clarify.
You got a concession?
I don't think that everybody that voted for Trump is racist.
Mm.
I think anybody that's supporting Trump now that's still supporting Trump after all this, mm-hmm, is definitely racist. All
right.
I believe there are a lot, there's a number, I don't know what the number is, there's a percentage of people that really just wanted to shake things up because they felt like they were getting shafted by the way things were going.
I mean, I'm pretty sure some white people who thought the Clintons were so bad,
yeah,
and all this other, yeah, stuff, and you know,
I
mean, what I'm saying?
Honestly, I don't even think it's really political. I think that if you look at the, like, after, and I think because people don't understand how things go. When Obama got in office and it was a recession and all this stuff was going and all these jobs left, blame the black guy.
Mm-hmm.
It was real easy to blame the black guy. Not realizing that the siege for what happened to you in 2013 was done in 2010. Or 20, you know what I'm saying, under Bush, and some of the stuff that Bush did,
mm-hmm,
led to a lot of deregulation that Bush did led to your factory leaving town and liquidating all that, right, stuff.
And then just technology, period.
Yeah. Or technology, all this other stuff. But the fact that, yeah, so yeah, a lot of stuff was inevitable. It just happened on the black guy's watch.
Right.
And so that's what turned them off. You know, so they was like, well, fuck them. Let's go a different way with it.
One day, I want to, not tonight, but one day, like, even going back and looking back on really what that Obama 8 years really meant and how it came about and what, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
Now looking back on it, like you had those thoughts like, damn, it was a lot of shit that you thought Obama couldn't do. Nah, he was just too classy to do it.
He was.
Nigga, you could have did it.
Yeah. But you know what?
You could have made the KKK guy on a goddamn, you could have went there and said, first thing first, KKK terrorist list.
Well, no, because this is the thing. The guy that would have done that wouldn't have got elected. The black person that would have done that wouldn't have got elected.
Yeah.
Is the problem.
And that, even that sore little subject for me right there. United States ain't never really gonna be about anything. If they can't admit that the KKK is, if they're not on a terrorist list,
then
this country really against us at the end of the day. They know.
It is. Absolutely. It is.
You know what I'm saying? That's like their backup plan, the KKK.
Let me ask you a question. Okay, well, I guess because, so, are the people that, I'm trying to figure out who is racist. And like, so the, are the people that turn a blind eye to racism racist? Are the people that
are
just like, man, look, I really just
want to,
like, look, I don't
want to
be involved. I just
want to kind of. Well, I would say history treated those people, the Jews who assisted Hitler.
Yeah.
They were treated that way. They were treated as just as bad as the Nazis. They weren't being, I'm saying the ones that weren't being persecuted and they decided that, okay, I got a job in this shit, so I'm just gonna roll with it.
Yeah,
when you find out 80 years old, that motherfucker out. Right.
But that's different. Because you're taking an active role. You're picking a side. What I'm saying is, say you're not the Jew that assisted him, but say the Germans that were just like, look, I don't want to be involved. Not a German that went and snitched on, okay, this family is Jew.
All right.
Another family was like, a Jewish family came in for help, and they're like, look, man, I don't want to be involved, bro.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? So I guess the equivalent would be, so the Trump support, again, because maybe I'm giving them too much credit. The Trump supporter, somebody that voted for Trump, somebody that ignored a lot of the bigotry and a lot of his history and the sexism and the bigotry and all of the isms, all the isms that Trump is guilty of.
All right.
The people that ignored that, are they racist? And vote for him anyway, are they racist? I mean, because...
And a commercial break.
Right.
I'm going to commercial.
Exactly. I ain't mean Jimmy Kimmel, y'all. You see what I'm saying? Because I feel like there's a line there. There has to be a delineation there from, or maybe it doesn't, because
yes,
ultimately, yes. If you benefit, I mean, because like I don't feel comfortable saying that if you benefit from racism, then you're racist.
I think so. Because you're not racist, and you're not showing it because you don't have to. It's almost like if we had a Black Panthers, and they was out here fucking shit up.
Mm-hmm.
But we ain't part of that shit. We living the lives that we live right now.
Mm-hmm.
They out here fucking shit up, and they making grounds in society. We like, but we still like low key in the back of their mind, like.
Do that shit.
You know what I'm saying?
That Trump was racist while he was campaigning.
Yeah.
You saw that?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, he the rallies, he like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, the rallies, when he kicked Black people out of his rally.
Yeah.
And then we told people, like, when people protest, beat the shit
out of
little,
down,
when he said Mexicans are rapists, when he made fun of handicapped dude.
Maybe so.
When he said grab him by the pussy, like.
Bring tequila.
Trump is a piece of shit. Yeah, bring the fuck. Trump's a piece. I mean,
wait. Grabbing pussy don't make you a racist.
That's
not racist. That's
misogynistic. Whatever it is.
Yeah.
I feel like Trump crossed a lot of lines.
Being gay and not liking pink might be a little racist.
Wow. You're a horrible person. Homophobe.
Watch my glasses.
But.
You want to put them on the couch, but they ain't gonna get set on that.
They are not.
I don't think that.
Anyway, let's take this topic.
Yeah, we're finna skate it because
I'm about to fall asleep.
Because I want to pull up. I was gonna tell Ava she could pull up the Nicki Minaj tweets.
No, let's talk
about her song.
We can talk about. You want to talk about her music first?
No, I just want to.
No, before we get into music, I feel like I'm gonna zone out. Let's wake Ava up. So, how did you feel about this bullshit ass show? And
it's
all the fuck
oh shit! I didn't watch it.
What's up?
Insecure. Oh, tell me about Insecure.
We'll talk about that next week.
Right, you need to put them come back.
I already posted about it, but I haven't really been able to engage like that.
I want to ask y'all a question. I read this somewhere. This is an excellent point. And it would probably make this chick Issa a genius if she did do this. Maybe we need to keep the question for next week. Are Issa and Lawrence the same person?
Mm.
Like, think about her situation how it is in the first episode. We'll get back to it. You know what I'm saying? Let's look back to it. We'll come back to it. Okay, let's take a look. We'll come back to it next
week. Okay.
So,
what make her a genius?
Huh?
What make her a genius?
But no, because he evolved.
So maybe she's on the way to doing that, though.
It's possible. Just not. I mean, it's possible. Because
she had a long way to go.
Yeah, because she effed up. Her career is effed up.
Well, we'll get into that. All
right. She ain't a teacher. Anyway, she ain't a teacher no more?
Huh?
She ain't a teacher no more?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna leave it alone. I ain't watching none of it. I ain't watching none this weekend. I ain't watched that Power shit. I ain't watched Snowfall.
I don't watch Power. Power's so fucking trash.
Is it?
It is.
I don't know if after the season of Power I'm gonna go watch.
It is impossible for the two ghosts to be the drug dealer he is with the dumb shit he be doing.
Because
he be doing the dumbest shit. And I feel like he do so much dumb shit to where the people around him are stupid for even telling him shit.
Right.
Because. You know what I'm saying? When Tasha told him about, I'm going to go and spoil it for you because you shouldn't be watching.
I mean, what's her name? Didn't the whole Rotimi shit didn't pan out?
It didn't because this motherfucker's stupid. Nothing panned out because Ghost is fucking stupid.
I'm just saying that I feel like I need to go back and watch season 5 because, no, what season are we in? 5. Season 4 because some of this shit just does not even make sense to me.
Like what?
And I feel like I missed something.
Like what?
Like the whole thing where
Tasha and that funny looking nigga.
I gotta over that because I'm like this
nigga.
Yeah.
I hate that nigga face.
No, I'm saying the whole part with Dre and his affiliations and how fast he got to where
he did speedball with all that.
I'm gonna kill this connect and this connect. I'm like, what did I miss?
Yeah, it's a lot going on.
The whole I need you to kill the connect ghost thing was kind of like, nigga.
Because now I'm like, wait a minute, what?
Like, and that's the thing. Now, mind you, now, like, Ghost and Tommy like, are straight killers. But this dude is untouchable to them. Like, this dude got them under their thumb.
Oh, yeah.
But now Drake's gonna go kill him?
I don't understand that. I don't understand that. If I'm a killer, I kill people.
Now, mind you,
if Kanan's fucking with me,
kill that nigga.
I'm gonna kill him.
Why don't you kill him?
Just kill him.
Like, forget that. Like, you got him arrested. And that's the thing. It started from the first season. Like, you got, before, because again, like, before they spoiled the whole thing that he got Kanan arrested, he set Kanan up. Mm. He went to Kanan for advice. He killed Rola on what Kanan said.
Right. Who are you talking about, Ghost?
Ghost.
I'm talking about Rotimi. What's the name of the show?
Dre.
Yeah. If he don't, like, why would you? When he was all scared of him.
Yeah.
Just shoot him.
Yeah. He coming to your hood.
Right.
And he's surrounded by your guys.
Shoot him. Why? What's the problem? Forget that.
If you goes, you come out of jail and you want to kill. I mean, if you Kanan, you get out of jail, you want to kill Ghost. So you playing all these psychological games and hanging with his son. Your fucking son got a key to his house.
Right.
Go over there and kill this nigga.
Yeah.
Shoot that little invisible baby.
Well, we know that's not gonna happen because Ghost is the show.
Best thing to happen in that show if Ghost get killed.
Nah.
If Ghost get killed?
Ghost get killed. It'll be awesome.
Tommy didn't die yet?
Nah.
Shit.
Tommy don't need to die.
Tommy dumb as hell too.
But that's Tommy's character though.
Right.
The whole conceit of the show is that Ghost is so smart to where he made all this happen. You know what I'm saying? And Tommy's just the muscle. Like, it's Tommy, 90% of the time, Tommy just lean back and let Ghost run shit. And now he kind of bucked against it a little bit, but even still,
but he
kind of
did that last season too, though. He made rational decisions.
But the thing is, because I think Tommy is smart enough to know he's not smart enough to be the man.
Let's talk about black wives cheating.
Oh shit.
Let's talk about the Tashas of the world.
Hold on. There's no even point to discuss.
Black men don't cheat, but black women do.
What do you mean? Angela?
She drove him to cheating.
He drove her to cheating.
Ghost drove Tasha to cheating.
Back popping in.
Hey, and for the record,
this is
when the nigga goes say that's some low shit. You stepping on me like that.
He said that.
It's Tasha. Remember when they was in the club?
I don't even know.
But he only fucked one chick in this show. She fucked about. She fucked four people.
He left his wife.
Wait, she did fuck.
She fucked the son. She fucked the lawyer.
That's two.
Well, okay.
Still two, one.
It doesn't matter.
Sure.
It don't matter.
Y'all like to whittle them down. We whittle them up.
Yeah.
y'all cut off.
The whole family for this bride that was willing to basically. Didn't she arrest him last season? Right. So
I mean. It's,
and she saved him at the same time. Angela, all right.
Whatever,
Angela. Angela.
She's a little bucket too, because you do the little FBI dude or whoever he was.
Yeah.
That was so stupid. You just,
oh, but Jamie didn't goddamn run her. He didn't make her do that?
Yeah. He did it. What? That was a get over ghost dick. That's all that was.
That's what I'm saying. He didn't drive. Ghost didn't drive her to that
dick? That was a get over ghost dick.
No.
I can't believe I called that nigga Jamie.
Yeah, you did. That was interesting.
Pause.
You know what? That was as bad as that ooh over.
Yeah.
So it happens, bro.
Yeah, it happens. Jamie, my fault.
Sit, Jamie.
You gotta be a meme out there about that niggas calling niggas Jay. When your guy calls Ghost Jay.
I guess you call him Brian too, huh?
No. Not do that.
Hey, you can because you're a girl.
So yeah, fuck this shit. What you think about Nicki Minaj album, by the way?
No, I only listened to one song.
Because I didn't think you would listen to it.
I couldn't bring myself to listen to
the
album.
Okay.
Dreams, whatever.
Yeah.
I listened to that song like five times.
It wasn't
that. No. Let me tell you what it was about that song. You were just like, dude. First of all, who wrote this song? I don't think he wrote this song. Number two.
If that was a man, you wouldn't say that.
Kim didn't write her shit?
Kim couldn't rap.
I'm sorry. Just so we clear.
I mean, it's the same
thing. So I say, I was kind of making the point that you're sexist and saying if you were talking about a man,
no,
you wouldn't have said that. And if you name another woman,
if Drake would have said it, I would have been like, who wrote Drake shit?
You see what I'm saying?
No.
If it was Drake's song, I would have said
double down.
Well, we all know Drake don't write his shit.
Exactly. We know Nicki don't write her shit.
I don't know that.
We don't know that. Did you listen to Funkmaster Flex?
I didn't really watch that. They
started all this shit today? That's what that shit was about. All this started from the Funkmaster Flex interview this morning.
I don't know why.
It was good. And I started off while I'm brushing my teeth, and I watched that whole shit this morning.
Was she actually being, like, authentic?
More than ever.
Okay. Because I feel like the last...
But she spent a lot of time going in on Savari.
Okay, because...
He brought it up. But she stopped.
She ran with it.
This is all I'm gonna
and
say,
she wasn't scared about. You know, you should be scared about names. She Meek this, Safari that.
No,
she going hard.
I feel like with the Nas Martinez this interview where she was supposed to be vulnerable after the breakup and all of that type of stuff. I feel like it was still calculated. It wasn't authentic.
This only reason this feels calculated is because the album dropping. That's the only reason. But at the same time, well, first about the dream song. What do you want to say about it? You didn't say.
No, I
cut you off. She was very adamant about writing her. She so much so that I just believe in her at this point. Because you can't die that hard about writing your own music. If you lying,
then it's gonna come out.
Yeah. She calling people that from back in the day. Did you ever see put them on speakerphone? She calling some nigga that work at Home Depot and shit. Like, did you ever see? Give me the other dude's number. Remember old boy? Give me his number too. I'm gonna call him. Like, she going really hard about, I ain't never had a nigga write one song for me. Ever.
I mean, I don't know, but I like it, but it just reminded me why I don't like her, too. It's like, I like it, and she kind of went hard on, like, the dudes that she was talking about. But what I don't like, it was just, like, the voices and then the whole vibe, because it's like, it's two songs in one, on one track. Yeah, because it's like that song kind of ends and then something else comes along. It's just like,
oh, really?
You know what I mean? So it's like the other song that comes along, it's like it definitely needs to be its own song. Like, it's not a bad song.
Oh, okay. We fake as hell. Well, I mean, how long are we going to hear about how she want to fuck niggas?
This
today,
but it ain't even how she want to fuck niggas. It's just like, well, she goes record, in on these dudes.
Not
like,
to humble brag, but I was listening to her when I was trying to work out to fit into these jeans. So, you know what I'm saying? I was more focused on really getting it in than really trying to hear what the fuck Nikki was saying. Yeah. So, I gave it a cursory
listen. No, it was cool, though. And I was just like, the whole time I was listening, I was just like, damn, if her and Kim would have did this shit would have been dope as hell.
And you know what, just real quick, I want to kind of apologize to Travis Scott, because like, I actually really sat down and listened to the album, like, yeah, it's
kind of
dope.
Yeah, yeah, it is, it is.
But,
yeah, it is.
You're not a music fan, you got a lot of people you don't fuck with. You're 90. Go ahead, Nikki, go.
Another thing I'm going to say about Nikki's interview, what was calculated about it, they did a whole hour and a half interview and didn't mention Cardi one time. The word Cardi never came up.
Because you already know when she came in, her PR people was like, we not talking that about was fake. This.
I hate that. It can only be one dope female at a time.
I mean, yeah, that's fucked up, but
if she would have went to Power, if she would have went to the Breakfast Club, Charlamagne would have brought that shit out.
Oh, yeah.
She's not going to go there.
That'd she don't want that
smoke. But she's not going to go there anymore.
She don't want that smoke. But I'm going to go there. Charlamagne's a rapist.
Yeah. Getting the fuck out of here.
I'm
going to take a picture of him and post it. Next time he wears his Brilliant Idiot shirt.
I want Charlotte face on.
I support the culture.
My sister hates Andrew Schultz.
I can see that.
She hates that dude.
All Right, Andrew.
Yeah, All Right, Andrew.
His comedy album is...
But then she likes the horrible... Show? What's them shits? Horrible Decisions podcast.
Oh.
Them chicks. Horrible.
I listen to that. I'm like, yeah, I can't do it. Right. I can't do it.
They out here drinking Coke.
Yeah. Like, they doing a lot. I'm like, yeah,
drinking Coke to get nut taste out their mouth.
But you know, it's weird because, like...
It was Coke, right? My fault. I said the wrong. I didn't
mean
it like that.
Did you see my face?
Anyway, so on local news. Shit. That's what we're doing?
You stupid.
That's how you feel?
That's the
thing. Damn. But no, she mentioned the nigga, Safari dude, right?
Nikki.
Nikki, yeah. She went in on him. She said the motherfucker was buying, he used her credit card to.
Flex
brought it up. In a roundabout way, thinking she was gonna do the normal shit, and she was like, "No, this motherfucker was like buying, using my credit card to buy prostitutes," and she started going in on a little tangent on what he used to do and all that bullshit, and then she kept going.
Like 2 years ago?
I mean, okay, he brought it up.
Yeah, he brought it up. It wasn't like she walked in there a lot with this shit. When they bring up something,
yeah, you got it.
We can't just take the snippet and be like, "Oh, why show they're talking about dude." No, she went to the radio station. And they started asking her questions.
Talking about her album, he asked, and then she, like I said, she's waiting on him to ask.
If he talked about it, track for track, she would talk about that. But instead of him talking about track for track, which song? Mm-hmm. Like he went all into the why you didn't put Nas on Dreams and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? And so giving her the opportunity to say, yeah, we dated,
and all this bullshit.
No, she ran. What'd you tell her? She said she had it on there, but she took it off. She had a lime there, but she took it off.
Some other shit. Dope, though. I ain't know if I
was. No, the lime was DJ Khaled. It was like, basically, I ain't got to let that nigga tell me what to do.
No, he ain't gonna eat, yeah.
Right.
She said, and I guess he replied to that shit. He was upset. Some niggas got upset. He got upset.
And that's the
thing. Who was he talking about with the lips? Who? Lips?
Who was that? It wasn't designer. She was
talking about. I don't know.
She called him retarded or something.
Yeah, she did. That was
then whoever one. Was like, what? Wait, Young Thug is talking about he was still in her dresses or some shit.
Yeah. It was a dope little joint. It was decent. You know what? I hate that people really get offended by something like that, man. Like, it's funny. Walk it off. Like, are you really going to get into a rap battle with Nicki Minaj?
I wonder if they feel offended with Kim. her record.
I think Kim, it was a different breed, Kim.
It was, but she did R&B dudes.
You know what I'm saying? But also, it was a different, it's just a different breed. And really, also, yeah. It was just like, beefing with Kim was beefing with Big, and nobody wanted that smoke.
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? Like, she was a main woman, like, nobody wanted that smoke. Also, it's just like, who really about to beef with a chick, though? Like, but I guess these, I think Young Thug would.
I'm not exclusive with though because they just made differently.
Yeah. They in touch with their feelings. Is something wrong with that?
I tried to listen to some of that album though, but I just don't I couldn't do it.
It wasn't bad.
Did this change your mind? Did she did this shit in 07? Talking about Hell Real.
Well, I think she upped her game a little bit. If you start out with Hell Real, we can only go south. So.
She's talking about Mano and shit.
Yeah. And I think that didn't blow up the Kevin's like, who?
I listened to it today. She's talking about J.R. Ryder.
Ooh, that's tough.
I
mean, so that's the thing. It's like,
Papoose. Like, you should have brought that shit up.
How do you beat with Kim when you was really zoning her a lot?
Exactly. Cool. And that's another thing that
Yeah.
But then it's like, okay, Big did it first, then Kim did it, then you did it.
Then she come back and do it again.
Right, you did it twice.
Big did it 20 years ago. Like, it's dope that
Hell, Kim did it on her album. 96.
20 years ago.
Right.
So it was about time somebody do it again. It's kinda dope though. This was up.
Oh, that's why I'm just like, I wish they
would. They say hers is a little bit different. I ain't gonna lie, I only listened to the song one time. And they say hers is different. And people are saying it's sort of like Dreams and How to Rob at the same time.
Dreams and How to Rob.
Like 50 Cent. They saying hers is a little bit, it's like it's got a and she's saying, and she's, they actually said this, and she's saying that's why she said 50's first. Cause it's really that. But it's over to the Dream theme, but she's really doing How to Rob.
Yeah. I mean, I can see it. Cause it's like you dissing.
I mean, it's a fun little song.
Cause what's the name was just talking about fucking him. Yeah. Biggie was just talking about him fucking.
And Kim was too, like. Yeah.
I mean, but you know what? I think just like it's a different kind of take because like I think Kim was selling sex more. So if I were to come out with a song like that, it was more about sex.
Well, her whole
Nicki is kind of trying to sell more of a, come out more as a solid MC, not as a sex pot, not as much as a sex pot. She kind of dabbles, but I don't think she lives in it like Kim did or Foxy did. Huh?
Content wise?
Yeah.
That song that she got with Foxy is garbage. I do listen to that song, it's just garbage.
She fucked with Foxy though. She fucked with Foxy.
It's garbage.
She fucks with Inga. Still deaf?
Nah.
She not on Def Jam. Ain't nothing
like
deaf.
Really deaf.
It don't even matter.
Which nothing is weird.
Inga, it don't even matter. That's just trash.
Inga had a run, though.
She did.
Yeah.
In the 90s.
You know when Kill Tony ran?
No, 2000s, wasn't it? No, 90s.
She had that verse on The Firm that didn't make no damn sense.
Which one?
When she was talking on Affirmative Action, when she was talking about selling drugs and then that.
But wait, though, but she had the joint with Case, though.
I had 18 at 1.1.
She redeemed herself, though.
No, it was dead, man.
It don't matter. She every time she came out with a different sound. So that's.
She definitely did with reggae.
You know what's crazy?
Reggae, she didn't. She died with reggae.
It was okay to know lyrics of hardcore when it came out for a dude. It was okay for a dude to rap, you know what I'm saying, if it came on the club, like, you had to kind of like, I mean, you ain't really come with the, I used to be scared of the dick. No, you kind of skipped that shit, but like,
right.
Like,
because it was hard.
That shit was tough.
It was hard.
Like, hardcore was tough, bro.
Hardcore, so, I mean, I think Lil Kim.
Huh?
Couldn't do that with Il Nana.
No, did you rock with Il Nana?
It was cool. I was cool with Kim. I like Foxy.
Foxy album.
Foxy was dope.
As an artist, I think Foxy was better.
She had with, musically, it was a little better. It was more,
definitely
it was
musically
more,
better, yeah.
More pop. More
and I think her, without a mentor, without a writer, when Lil' Kim went without, and Foxy went without, Foxy was better.
Yeah, I can see that.
I mean, they both was not Eve.
Really,
But you know what?
She just went reggae. She just turned all the way reggae when she had to go by herself.
The problem is, it's hard not to take what actually happened into the conversation when you compare them to
it. The whole situation of, but like...
Just the fact that Lil' Kim had a whole career and Foxy had a moment. So it's hard to retroactively come back and say, well, not. I mean, it's like the you know what?
But it's kind of...
How many albums did you give Kim?
It's kind of trying to have the... Up until the Notorious K.I.M., that was like 3 or 4 albums.
But you know what, though?
Foxy had an album, bro.
What's Lil' Kim's second album?
I don't know.
Because I can tell you Ill Nana, Broken Silence.
You know what it is, though? You know what it is? It's like trying to have a Kobe T-Mac conversation now. Because you know how, like, it was a, man, who better, Kobe or T-Mac? You sound stupid as fuck saying that now. But at the time...
T-Mac was nice.
T-Mac was like, I was on T-Mac. I was
seeing
T-Mac like a
motherfucker. T-Mac was nice.
So it's the same thing when you say who better, Lil' Kim or Foxy. At the time, it was a competition. But now, it's a stupid-ass question.
And it's stupid because I don't think either one of them was Eve. Even though I ain't with Tina Turner, I'm mad.
Ooh.
But as at that moment, Rough Rider Eve... And even Gwen Stefani Eve.
Yeah.
Neither one of them was that.
But the thing is.
And I literally rode around with niggas listening to Eve.
I don't know if I was rapping. I could rap with Pitbull in the skirt.
What? I rode around with because it was so much Rough Rider on that.
You know what it is, and that's the thing, because it was so much. Exactly.
Yeah, yeah. I literally, niggas actually listened to rode around with
something. Rough Rider was so tough. I bought a Drag On album, bro.
I ain't about that album.
That shit was so trash.
But he ain't bad. He ain't even bad right now. He be doing little freestyles. But ain't nobody fucking with him.
That album was trash.
Was it?
He's the Memphis Bleek of the Rough Riders.
Sorry, I'm getting for me today.
But we you can just do that. That's a thing. That's an option.
Well, shit. You know what? But now y'all get out of me. Fuck, you know.
Okay.
Prove you ain't light skin. You ain't got the light skin privilege no more, baby. Get your ass up.
You ain't even serious because you...
My chest is white skin.
Is it?
Yo, what?
I got jungle fever. Like, my whole...
Somebody did this shit this weekend. You ever been with a chick and she just started talking some shit? And you be like, whoa. What the fuck, a few minutes ago, start telling us how her vagina too fat? But we like... We tried to like... Bad guy, she keep coming with it. I'm gonna have to get it. I'm fucking around. I don't care. I'm gonna get a goddamn surgery.
It don't even matter.
Is there like a?
I asked that question. So really, okay, so that's really a thing. Hell yeah, it's a thing. Cause mine is overwhelming. Yeah. Okay. No, you said the titties was light skin.
I'm just saying. You know what?
On wax, you said that.
You just farted in front of us.
Not a fan, thanks for shit.
You just invited us to your ass.
I'm a happy married man, madam. Thank you very much.
But I don't know. But the other shit, that's what I want to talk about. So how you feel about the Safari nigga though? And
I don't
even
know
shit.
What's going on. I missed the beat.
Oh, you missed the beat? So Nicki, they've been going back and forth.
What team
are you on?
We do homework. I'm definitely not on Team Safari.
I don't care because I don't like either one of them.
It's not about life. It's about liking your team.
Well, I don't know. Give me what's going on.
Nicki is the woman who made all the money that she got on. And he's a man that's... And he supported her.
I don't know.
But he was too insecure, so he started fucking chicks.
He was writing her music, though.
I don't believe that. That's unfounded.
I heard his music.
That's fake news.
He wouldn't write her music.
Right, right. She said that in the interview. That nigga didn't rap. She called another nigga. Can he rap? No.
You know what?
This shit do not slap.
Wait, but let me say how I feel about this, though, because I feel like when you break up from somebody, a relationship, a friendship, I feel like it's so whack for you to go on, like, this media frenzy dissing them.
So she said he did it. She said he went out there and did the one thing that she knows he holds true to her heart. He went out there and said he wrote her raps. Because he knew that was going to piss off.
Okay, fine. But
so would that be like your ex guy going to tell him that her titty thirsty?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I just feel some type of way. So I feel some type of way about both of them. Because y'all airing dirty laundry. And I don't like that shit. I feel like I just broke up with a friend that we've been friends for like 20 plus years. I would never tell her secrets. Even though I'm not fucking with her anymore, I would never, ever, ever tell her secrets.
What if she was shit talking to you?
I wouldn't do it.
Does she wear glasses?
No.
Okay.
Don't try to narrow your shit down. You're not going to do it. You never met.
Is she single?
No. She's married.
Mm.
I know who it is.
She broke up with you. She left you.
Hell yeah.
she got out the game on your ass.
Even though
I'm out here hating and shit on her marriage.
No, but my whole point is, even though right now we aren't seeing eye to eye and I'm like, she's on an extended time out, I would never, ever, ever.
She done some whole shit? You can tell us.
No, but I would never disclose anything.
You fucked up, man.
Are you freaking kidding me right now?
She did some whole shit.
No, whole shit in terms, what's whole shit?
She fucked your man?
No, it wasn't even nothing like that. It didn't have anything to do with a man.
She went to Freaknik?
She fucked your friend?
Freaknik.
Then she go to Freaknik.
Is that so funny?
I didn't know her in 94.
Yeah, no, you said 20 years.
Yeah,
it is. 2018, 98.
And there we have it, folks. She's 53 years old.
Does she? Why you stop hanging with her then?
I'm not gonna talk about this right here on this tape, which is my whole point. But no, but this is
53 year old people still think it's tape.
My whole point is, so this is why this whole Nicki Minaj and the Safari shit is whack to me, because it's like y'all airing dirty laundry, and I don't like that shit. And I don't even know what happened. I guess
theirs is elevated. Theirs is elevated.
I kind of feel like Safari feel a way that the only reason he's famous is because he happened to be fucking Nicki.
I mean, but that's true, right?
Well, she said that, and what's wrong with that, though?
I mean, but that's the reality.
I imagine you want to be famous on your own.
But we know him because of his affiliation with Nicki Minaj.
Like, he like a real housewife without a housewife.
But she only famous because of Lil Wayne, but it don't work for women.
Well, no, because she's actually talented.
That's different, though.
Talented. She's famous because she puts out music that people want to hear. Lil Wayne got her on.
Rhapsody puts out music, but she's not famous.
Music that people want to hear.
Yeah. That don't make you famous because you put out Mother. Yeah, she do.
No. Because they didn't, she would get more spins than she does.
I like Rhapsody.
Yeah.
She don't have that whole look. She don't have
good music.
She don't have that look. What look?
The look.
What's the look?
The
oh,
look.
Shit. We got another subject. What do you mean she doesn't have the look?
She can sing, but she doesn't make great songs.
3D, listen to your girl got the look.
Who?
3D and a T. She's
her name is Wax. Oh, she's never going to be popping because of her name.
I get mad when they don't mention her. They be like, it's female MCs out here. They be like, Rapsody. I be like, 3D, not T. I be mad. Nobody want to say the name.
Listen, I was trying to tell this chick about her, and I was like, fuck, I can't think of her name. Like, her name.
You just don't want to be the goofball to say it and fuck it up, and they be like, huh?
She should just cut it to 3D.
Her name is Killer.
Because, like, the roots were the square roots. She was in 80.
Yeah.
They
were square roots?
They were square roots.
Get the fuck out of here.
How nerdy that shit is. And now the roots is some cool ass shit, though.
Yeah.
With square roots? Yeah, man. Imagine listening to them.
I would have lost that on Jeopardy.
Bruh.
Shit. The square roots?
I don't give a fuck how dope silent treatment is. You know what I'm saying? Like, nah, man.
Square roots.
Ain't nobody checking for the square roots. But the roots? That's how neo soul, don't it?
Yeah.
They started out some nerdy shit. They tripping to that neo soul shit. And I'm not giving a fuck about Questlove Afro.
Right, because the roots.
Questlove or the square roots.
Hold on, I'm a huge fan of the roots.
The square roots, though?
You been to see them live?
I've seen them live like 5 times.
Would you go watch them if they were the square roots?
I would do it. I like Questlove.
Don't picture that tree. You don't picture that tree with the roots.
No.
No
black fish.
Fucking rhombus is their symbol.
They can do no wrong in my eyes. And I'm going to the picnic.
Name matters.
You going to the picnic? The roots picnic?
Yeah, next year.
You living this life.
Nah.
I'll start restarting. We stopped about say 40 minutes. you go to Roots Picnic for real?
Next year I'm gonna go.
Okay.
I hate stuff like that. It'd be too packed, man.
But I gotta go.
Some of them is like, fuck it, because I don't want to be the cat that missed all that shit
Roots
later on in life.
What is this thing? What does it do?
It already happened, but I'm going next year. I think it happened.
She's a genius at not answering questions.
What'd you say?
What the fuck is it?
Probably. What does that matter?
I guess so.
I like that shit, bro. Probably. What does it matter?
What does that matter?
Made in America. It's a lot of shit I wouldn't mind going to. I won't go to them. I wouldn't mind going to Made in America.
Made in America. I'm put that on my list.
What is that?
You doing all kind of shit while he in college.
Are you kidding me? Exactly. I'm free. Mama.
Made in America's concert.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
These all
in Philadelphia.
Why don't y'all come to, on the road with me in Nashville? I'm still
still. We are going to Nashville.
Ain't nobody
I'm
trying to
see. I'm the one in Houston, but I don't really want to see them.
You know, I definitely
want to. I'm going to the one in Houston.
Oh, shut the fuck up. I don't want to.
Music
Fest? The who? Oh, the One Music Fest? I need to do that. I'm talking about these festivals. I forgot about that shit.
Where's that at?
That's yeah, Atlanta. That's Atlanta. That's Atlanta.
In Atlanta.
We're
going
to do the show on location?
Ooh, that would be dope.
I can do that. I can do that.
I'm going to be able to put some things in motion. No.
Mike, work the drunk ass out of here.
No.
Tomorrow she'll be like, fuck that,
that
shit.
No people that know
me. I ain't got no fire pit.
Right.
I'm gonna give you my fire pit.
Oh, y'all got, you heard that right?
I'm gonna give it
both of y'all heard that right.
And for the record, fire pit is a fire pit.
Yeah. I'm about to get the
fire pit down.
I'm going to give you my fire pit.
What is Jesus?
It's what she said.
What does fire pit mean, Tommy?
I'm
going
to trust you.
This is
South.
Y'all ready?
Yeah.
Quickly.
Omarosa, Nicki Minaj, Safari, we're done.
Power to the black woman.
Issa.
Boo.
First of all, you haven't even watched this.
Black women is wilding. That's the point.
Real quick.
Black women what?
Black women is out here wilding.
Soon they get away from good men.
Yeah, they wilding out.
Omarosa left Donald Trump. She got the wilding. Nicki left Safari. Got the wilding. Issa left Lawrence. Got the wilding, man. It's clear. Y'all gotta find
actually,
a man
Lawrence
that makes you his God. That's what y'all
Lawrence
find.
Actually left Issa.
All because she. I'm not even about to be a hoism. But for the record, y'all need to find a man that thinks makes you his God.
Oh my God. Go to sleep.
That's what you need to do.
That's malarkey.
That's my new 40,000.
That is malarkey. And I need you to come up with something better.
Oh, shit.
It's garbage.
That works.
Tide's garbage.
So,
it's a wrap.
It's a wrap.
God bless. Good night.
So to all our fans that would listen to the album, progressively fall asleep during the podcast. She loves
you. All bore me.
Except you in Australia, we still love you. I was about to say,
no,
if you think we're brilliant, I'm about to show you
something. Yeah, yeah. So you listen to Brie. It is like that. I listen to Joe, but I got to stop myself from doing that Joe.
Bro, I like it. Wow, I'm really about to go in.
Sometimes I want to be like, so are there any sleepers? Let's play some music.
We're going to get back to that. We're going to do it. What's the ugly truth for pretty life? We're going to start doing that.
Yeah, really about
that. So the ugly truth is that you women out here lost without a man.
That's a lie.
That's what it was on, yeah. We was doing the ugly truth.
A lie.
Black women is out here wilding.
A lie.
From Omarosa to Nicki, and they all got left by their men, and now they lost.
A lie.
The pretty lie.
A lie.
Is that all the people that just still support Trump
lives.
Is racist?
They're upgrading their lives.
You know, what's a pretty lie?
You can't upgrade what.
I don't know, whatever, man. We gone. Bye.
I never figured out how to do the pretty lie.
Yeah, I guess.
I can do the ugly truth, but I don't know how to do the pretty lie. That's why I never held on to it.
The pretty lie, you women out here doing just fine. I'm gonna do the pretty
we
lie.
We are, though. That is.
I got
that's not
you. Got this?
Lie.
See?
What you say?
We are, though. That's not a pretty
lie. I forgot the pretty lie. Y'all ain't hot. Y'all good.
Y'all good.
Y'all can do bad on all y'all damn
y'all
self.
Think we out here.
On niggas couch to sleep.
Shout out to Mary J. Blige.
This is what y'all doing on cast couch to sleep. Well, back shots to be given and y'all ain't getting them.
Yeah.